Hey everyone! Welcome to this channel. Welcome to this video. I am Amy and this is my smoothie. And now we're ready to go after I take a sip. Not bad, not too sweet. Surprised the ice cream didn't add too much sweetness. Anyways, in this video, I'm gonna go over what I do day to day as an investment banking analyst at my firm. I'm gonna go over like what I actually do, as in like specifically what I actually like click and do on my laptop, to just give you guys a good sense of what your day might look like if you do pursue the investment banking path. So I would categorize my day as two types of work I do. One is just random things that like senior bankers are just like, hey, can you help me with this? Oh, hit the table. And the second thing, or the second group I would say, is actually for the deals I am on. So for example, in a given day, I can suddenly get an email from like a more senior banker, and he might go, here are the deals that I've done, like the senior banker has done. Can you make them into a tombstone? So what tombstones are, essentially, I think the name is really funny and scary for it. It's just imagine a PowerPoint and then imagine little boxes. And essentially what it is, it's just that you just show what kind of work you've done or what projects you've done to other potential investors to build your credibility. So in the box, it'll be like, this logo has acquired this other logo for like this much money, and then essentially when you put it on that slide, it just means that this banker participated in doing this deal. So it's just essentially like your resume-ish, but for either the team or the banker to just go like, you just insert that slide in like your deck for other people, and you go like, oh yeah, like this is just like what I've done, these are all the deals that I've participated in, etc., etc. So essentially a lot of it just comes down to manual work. So you need to like go find the logos, and then you need to go to the website to make sure that logo on Google is recent. We also use websites called logo, like one is called Logo Intern, where essentially you really just, it's a website for you to just enter the company name, and then it pops up the logo, and you could download the logo in a PowerPoint format for you to easily copy and paste to your PowerPoint. So there are a lot of websites that help with this, which is very helpful. So there's some random stuff like that. There's other random stuff like, hey, can you go on this platform? For example, we use a platform called CapIQ, Capital IQ. It's a big database where I'm like, I want to see these companies and I want to see their recent stock prices. And I want to see like stock price chart all in one chart. So what I have to do is like go to that platform, go to that website, like AKA the website. The platform even has this like functionality called chart builder. So you just input each company name and then you press like, I want to see the stock price, and then it graphs it for you. And then you need to format it in the way that the senior banker wants to format, or there usually are templates, like what kind of color lines you use, all of that good stuff. So those are some like examples of the random things that are just on the side that some people would just like ask if you can help them with that. So in the second group, we have things that I actually do for the deals I am on. So for example, like a company is trying to raise capital, right? They want some money, and then who should they find? That's one question. So from the start to finish, for example, I would go on this one platform that we use a lot called PitchBook. And essentially this one platform online is just that you can screen companies. So you could go through this like company screener, and you type like, I want like a technology company, and then they should be in whatever industry, and then the company search criteria, you can narrow it down to search for all the relevant companies you want. And then you're like, oh, maybe because the deal is in tech, so I want a technology investor because It can be like a strategic fit or something like that. And that's why you use technology as your criteria. And you can be like, oh, it needs to have at least this much market cap, or it needs to be big enough to give us this much money, or I want it to be small because we want them to care about us. Just a lot of different criteria that you would work out with the other people you're working with. And after you search for that, you press search. And then you curate like a huge list. Later you work with your coworkers to narrow down the list. And then that's just for like one pull. So we call that like pulling companies. Like another task I would do for deals are, now that we have these company names, how do we find like a contact inside the company that we can literally email and go like, are you interested in this opportunity to invest in this company that we represent? So on PitchBook, for example, on a lot of these platforms, they actually do have like specific contact areas that you can just click into, and then you can copy and paste onto another Excel, and then make a big list of this company. There's like this person we can contact, this position that this person contact holds at this company in their email address. So you do that also for a bunch of companies. So a lot of these things don't require too much, I would say, hard mathematical thinking, for example, but it does require you to think logically. Like if I find a big company and I want them to be an investor, does the contact that is actually their like the CEO email address, like are they actually going to respond to us if we email them straightforwardly? So it's best there are other ways to find contacts that have like more relevant positions that we want, and we should find those contacts. But yeah, so that's for finding contacts, creating a big contact log, and then you send it to your senior banker on the team for them to like maybe contact. Another thing that we do is, you know, create pitch material. So usually a lot of the times, for me at least, like for example, a senior banker will reach out and go like, can you pull this slide, this slide, this slide, bunch of these slides from this one deck, can you pull these other slides from this deck, and then put it together. So it's pretty straightforward during these times where you just go to that PowerPoint, put it in one PowerPoint, and then you take other PowerPoint slides, shove it in, and then everything just comes in a good PowerPoint. So those are more straightforward and pretty quick, unless you realize something's wrong, like that deck is actually, the PowerPoint you just pulled from wasn't updated. There are a lot of things that you have to check for, and usually the person right above you who's working closest to you, he or she will also help you check these materials. Another thing that we do that is time consuming but necessary is that after we get these investors, what do we do with them? Or like at the beginning of the process, for them to continue looking at our company materials once they're more interested, we need to get them to sign our NDA. So what analysts usually are tasked to do is organizing, handling all the NDA processes for all of these investors for that one deal. For example, after an investor says like, oh, I am interested in it, can you send me more material? Can you send me the NDA? We have to give them, or like usually it's helpful that we give them our form of NDA and then have them either go through it with their own legal team, and then they go like, oh, we want to change this or not. Or most of the time they're just like, okay, and then they maybe change a few words there and there, and then they sent it over. And then you have that edited NDA with comments. You send it to the legal team of the company that you represent. And then that company, like the company we represent, they would go like, okay, looks good, they can sign it. And then you tell the investor company that, hey, like we're good for your side to execute the NDA. So AKA that they could just sign it and we're good with the changes that you made to our NDA. So the investor signs it, sends it back to you, and then I go and send it to our the CEO of the company we represent and go like, hey, everyone signed off on it, we just need your signature. And then the CEO responds, you know, and then he sends you the finished, fully executed NDA, and then you're good to go. So what's time consuming about this is that you might reach out to 100 investors and they all might be interested, and you have to do this entire process for each of them. So that can be a long day for you, but it's time consuming, but it is necessary. And I almost forgot to drink my smoothie. The last thing that I would want to mention is we also have something called process tracking. So you know how you have all these investors, you want to know which stage each investor is in. For example, like one investor can still be in the process of signing the NDA, while another investor can already be in the process of looking into more specific, more confidential information like your financial model, and they can be in another stage. Some investors already declined, said that no, sorry, we're passing on this opportunity because of whatever reasons. Or some investors are you just contacted and you haven't heard back. So through all these processes, it's really helpful if you have another Excel template that other people or other coworkers have given you to like update every investor's information. Go like, oh, this company at this was the date last contacted, it's in this process, they did this. And it's just like an overall good gist, an overview of the process of where each investor is in. And this is just helpful in general for, you know, the whole team and for the company that you represent, because you would want to update them weekly or something like that and go like, we've contacted this, this is what process we are on. You know, good customer management skills, as like the company we represent are our clients. So we want to tell them how efficient we are and what we're in. That's all for now for today's video. Thank you for listening in or watching or whatever however you're playing this video. That is what I would typically do, maybe day to day. Like there are other days where it's just meetings where we're updating company info, or like we're updating the management team of the company we represent about like how the process is going. Other meetings, maybe like HR meetings, for example. But yeah, all in all, those are some typical things that I've been doing these last few months. I hope that was helpful for you to get a better gauge at what investment banking as an analyst looks like. And I will see you in the next one. Bye.